Hello everyone, welcome to Math EduTalk. Then today we study the most important topic, linear equation in two variables. Then let us start definition. What is mean by linear equation in two variables? That is an equation which contain two variable and the degree of each term containing variable is 1. The variable means this x, y, z, we call this as a variable. When we consider the equation ax plus by, in that this a and b are the real numbers, that is a constant term, and this x and y are the variables. Then here x and y variable, either you can use different variable also, that is m, n, u, v, okay, these are the variables and these are the constant term. Then degree of a variable, the degree of each term containing variable is 1, means here if you observe the equation, that is x raised to power is 1, means here degree is 1. If x raised to power is 2, then degree is 2. If y raised to power is 2, then degree is 2. Then same thing, if we consider x raised to 3 power, x raised to 4 power, then degree is 3, degree is 4. But only up to this standard, 10th standard, you have to study in the chapter number 1, the linear equation in two variables of degree 1, means raised to power is 1. Then the general form of linear equation in two variables, that is the standard form, ax plus by plus c is equal to 0, is our general form of the linear equation in two variables, means x, y is a variable and this a, b, c are the real numbers, that is having some constant values. Then this a and b, there is a condition when we consider equation x plus by plus c is equal to 0, this value of a, b is not equal to 0 at the same time, means either a is 0 but b is not equal to 0. Then when b is 0, then a is not equal to 0, means you have the equation, suppose 2x plus some constant is equal to 0, in that the y term is not present, means coefficient of y, this x plus by plus c is equal to 0, that is the coefficient of y is 0, means we get only equation 2x plus 5 is equal to 0. Or if the coefficient of x is 0, then this coefficient of y is not 0, means suppose 3y plus 10 is equal to 0, that is this coefficient of a and b both are not at a time 0. Okay, then we can see, for example, 3x minus 4y plus 12 is equal to 0, general form of equation. This general form is x plus by plus c is equal to 0. This is linear equation in two variables. Then the linear equation in two variables, in standard also you have studied simultaneous linear equation and how to solve the simultaneous linear equation. Simultaneous linear equation means, which is also a linear equation, but when we consider two linear equation in two variable at the same time. For example, 2x plus 3y plus 5 is equal to 0, then 3y plus 3x plus 5y plus 10 is equal to 0, then this is a simultaneous equation. Then how to solve the simultaneous equation? Then solve the following simultaneous equation. How to solve the simultaneous equation? Then consider one equation. To solve the simultaneous equation, first we observe the coefficient of x and y. If both the coefficients are same, then we directly take either addition or subtraction and we cancel out either x term and we find the value for y, or either we cancel out the y and we find the value for x by adding and subtracting the equation first and second. Then here, for this first equation, 5x minus 3y is equal to 8. Second equation is 3x plus y is equal to 2. Here, the coefficient of x is 5, here is 3. Here, coefficient of y is 3 and here is 1. But here, sign is negative and here sign is positive. Means here, if here we have 3y and if we take the addition, then this y is get eliminated. And remaining is only in terms of x. But when we get here 3y, that is, for that, we have to multiply this equation second by 3. Then in order to get the same term here, we multiply equation second by some constant 3. Therefore, we get the equation 5x minus 3y is equal to 8. And second equation, when we multiply by 3, that is 9x here plus 3y is equal to 6. And then take addition, then adding these two equations here, this 9x plus 5x means 14x, and this plus minus get cancelled, and here is also 14. And from that we get x is equal to 1, that is dividing both sides by 14. Now transfer this 14, here we get divided and we get value for x as 1. Then after getting the one variable value, substitute this value of one variable in either equation 1 or equation 2, any one of these. Then if we substitute x is equal to 1 in equation second, then put x is equal to 1 in equation second, we get this second variable value, means 3 into x plus y is equal to 2 is the equation second. Substitute x as a 1 means 3 into 1 plus y is equal to 2, means here y is equal to, if you transfer this 3 here, 2 minus 3 means y is equal to minus 1. That is, the solution of the given simultaneous equation is x is equal to 1, y is equal to minus 1. Or also we can write this in terms of order pair, that is xy is equal to 1 minus 1, which is the solution. For the next one example, if you observe the given equation, the coefficient of x is 15 and coefficient of y is 17 in the equation 1. And second equation, coefficient of x is 17 and second is 15. Means here coefficient of x and y is just interchange. Then such type of an example, always remember, if you have such type of a simultaneous equation, then first take addition, we get one equation, and second take subtraction of these two, we get second equation, and we solve these two equations to find the value of x and y. What we do, first we take a addition, then we get 32x plus 32y is equal to 32. Then which is divisible by 32 means divide by 32. Whole equation means simplify equation is x plus y is equal to 1. We call this as next equation. And then again we get, if we take a subtraction of these two, then we get, if we take subtraction, subtracting, taking subtraction here, minus 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 means 15 minus, this has minus 10, and this has the upper term having positive sign, means this is plus 2y is equal to, here also positive sign, the lower term having negative sign, then this has 10. That is, we get equation minus 2x plus 2y is equal to 10, which is divisible by 2, means if we divide by 2, then minus x plus y is equal to 5. In solving this equation 3 and this equation 4, taking addition, adding, we get this and this get cancelled, plus minus, then 2y is equal to 6, y is equal to 3. Then substitute y is equal to 3 either in equation 3rd or 4th. Therefore, if we use equation 1st, that is 3rd, then y is equal to 3, that is x plus 3 is equal to 1, that is x is equal to 1 minus 3, x is equal to minus 2. Therefore, we get a solution of simultaneous equation as x is equal to minus 2, y is equal to 3, that is xy is equal to minus 2, 3 is a solution. The practice set 1.1, solve the following simultaneous equation. First equation, this is second equation. If you observe the whether the coefficient of A and B are equal or not, here coefficient of B and here also coefficient of B is same thing. That is, if you take a subtraction, then this B and B get cancelled, 5B and 5B, and we get the value for A. Then first we take subtraction, that is, if coefficient is directly same, then directly take addition or subtraction. If opposite sign, then take addition. If same sign, then take subtraction. And then if coefficient is not same thing, then we make same coefficient by either multiply equation some value and multiply equation second by some value, and then taking subtraction or addition. Here the coefficient of B is same, then we directly take subtraction, then there's 5 and this 5 get cancelled. When we take subtraction, minus minus, then here is remains twice A is equal to 26 minus 22, that is 4, means A is equal to 4 by 2, that is A is equal to 2. Then we put this value of A in either in equation 1 or 2. Then we use the equation second, A plus 5B is equal to 22, that is, if we substitute A as a 2 plus 5B is equal to 22, means 5B is equal to 22 minus 2, that is equal to 20, means 5B is equal to 20, that is B is equal to 4, means solution is A is equal to 2 and B is equal to 4. Given equation, here the y is positive and here y is negative, then If we take addition, here is opposite sign, then this term get cancelled. But for that, we have to make the coefficient of y same thing. When we get same coefficient for that, multiply this 7 to the second equation and this 2 to the first equation. Okay, after multiplying the addition of these two equation, this plus this 23x, this and this get cancelled. Then this are 69. 69 divided by 23, which is equal to 3, means x is equal to 3. Then substitute this value of x either in equation 1 or 2. Then if we use equation 1, then we get 7y is equal to 10 minus x. Okay, here 7y is equal to 10 minus x. Then substitute value of x, that is 7y is equal to 10 minus x is 3, that is 7y is equal to 7, means y is equal to 1. Therefore, the solution of simultaneous equation is xy, that is x is 3 and y is 1. For the equation, this 2x minus 3y is equal to 9, and this one, the x having the same coefficient, that is if you take a subtraction, then this x term get cancelled. Then subtraction means when having a same, directly same term and same sign, then take a subtraction, and when opposite sign, then take addition. But here for opposite sign 3y, but here is y, then it is better to take subtraction, means x get cancelled. Then when we take subtraction, minus minus, this is minus, then this and this get cancelled. Here is minus 4y and is equal to minus 4, means y is equal to negative negative, means minus 4 divided minus 4. This has a positive term, means y is equal to 1. Substitute y is equal to 1 in either in equation 1 or 2. We substitute y is equal to 1 in equation first, that is 2x minus 3y is equal to 9, means 2x is equal to 9 plus 3y. When we transfer to right hand, it is positive. When 2x is equal to 9, substitute y as a 1, means 9 plus 3 is equal to 12 is there. That is, 2x is equal to 12. Then divide this coefficient of x in order to find the x. Means 12 divided by 2 is equal to 6. Means we get x is equal to 6. Therefore, the solution is xy is equal to x is 6 and y is 1. That is, okay, when same sign, then always we take subtraction. And when opposite sign, then we take addition. Means when n having same sign, then subtraction, or m having same sign, then subtraction. That is, in order to cancel out m or n term. Here, if you want to cancel out the n, then for that we have to make here 6 and then we take subtraction. Okay, then here we multiply equation 1 by 2. Then after multiplying, we get 10m. That is, when we multiply this, means for left hand as well as right hand, minus 6n is equal to 38. And here this remain as it is, minus 6n is equal to minus 7. Take subtraction, means here when take a subtraction, the sign are opposite, means get a reverse. This has minus and here minus, then plus, here minus, then plus. Then this has 9m is equal to, this has 45. Then m is equal to, we get value for m is equal to 45 divided by 9, means 9 is, this as m is equal to 5, means m is equal to 5. Substitute this value of m in either equation 1 or 2. Okay, then we substitute this value of m in equation 1 or equation 2. Suppose we take equation second, that is m minus 6n is equal to minus 7, means minus 6n is equal to minus 7. When we transfer this m, minus m, and substitute m as 5, means minus 6n is equal to minus 7 minus 5, means minus 12 is there. That is, n is equal to, divide this, minus 12 divided minus 6, both are negative, means positive, and 12 divided by 6 is 2, means n is equal to 2. That is what we get the solution as n m, that is n is 2, m is 5. We make the coefficient of x as same and take the subtraction. Here 5x is already, if we multiply take second equation by 5, then here we get 5x. Then multiply second equation by 5, we take subtraction, that is minus minus minus. This and this get cancelled. Here is 23y minus 10 is equal to minus, and this minus 23, that is y is equal to minus 23 divide this minus 23, minus 23 divided minus 23, means y is equal to 1. Substitute y is equal to 1 in either equation 1 or 2. If you substitute in equation 2, that is x plus 5y is equal to 4, y x is equal to 4 minus 5y, then substitute y as a 1, that is x is equal to 4 minus 5 into y is 1, that is 4 minus 5 minus 1, means x is equal to minus 1. That is, we get a solution xy as x is minus 1 and y as 1. First we simplify this equation 1 as well as equation 2. Means here this p upon q form is present. Means multiply whole over the equation by 3. And here also multiply whole over the equation by 4. When we multiply by 3, then 3 upon 3, that is 3, 3 get cancelled. Simplify equation x. When we multiply 3, that is 3y, is equal to 11 by 3 into 3. Means remain is 10. That is we have multiplied left hand as well as right hand. Here also when we multiply by 4, means here 4 into 2x, that is 8x. Plus, when we multiply second term also 4, 4 into 1 by 4, 4 per get cancelled, remain is y. Is equal to, when we second, here also multiply by 4, this and this get cancelled, remain is 11. And after that, we have to simplify this. Means here we make the same coefficient of x, for that, multiply first equation by 8. Okay, same coefficient and same sign, then take subtraction of these two. Then this and this get cancelled, here 23y is equal to 69, that is y is equal to 69 divided by 23, that is 3. Then subtract y is equal to 3 either in this equation or this equation. Suppose we use this equation 8x plus y is equal to 11, and that subtract y as a 3 means 8x is equal to 11 minus y, that is 8x is equal to 11 minus 3 is 8. Then 8x is equal to 8, that is x is equal to 1. Means solution x is equal to 1, y is equal to 3 is the solution. For the simultaneous equation, coefficient of x and y are reverse, the opposite of each other. Means in first equation, coefficient of x is 99 and equation second, coefficient of y is 99. In first equation, coefficient of y is 101. In second equation is 101 of coefficient of x. Then in such type of an example, take addition of these two equations, we get one equation. And after that, second, take subtraction, we get another equation. And then solve these two equations to find the value of x and y. Then first adding these two equations, we get 200x plus 200y is equal to 1000. Then whole this equation is divisible by 200, then dividing 200, x plus y is equal to 5, we call this as equation 1. Then second, taking subtraction, that is minus 2x, here we get plus 2y is equal to minus 2, this is divisible by minus 2, then we get x minus y is equal to 2, is equal to 1 as equation second. Then we solve 1 and 2, equation 1 and 2, that is x plus y is equal to 5, and second x minus y is equal to 1. Then adding these two, y and this plus y and minus y get cancelled, then 2x is equal to 6, that is x is equal to 3 value. Then substitute this x is equal to 3 either in this first equation or in first equation or this second equation. Then if x plus y is equal to 5, if we substitute x as a 3, means y is equal to 5 minus 3. When we transfer this, x here minus x and x is 3, means y is equal to 2, that is the solution is x is equal to 3, y is equal to 2. Then same thing as last one example, here also for both the equation coefficient of x and y are opposite of each other. Then here first taking addition, then this equation is divisible by 106, then dividing we get x minus y is equal to 4 as equation 1. Then call this as equation 1. The second, taking subtraction of these two, then subtracting we get minus 8x minus 8y is equal to minus 80, which is divisible by minus 8. Then after dividing we get x plus y is equal to 10. And first equation is x minus y is equal to 4. Then solving this equation 1 and 2, this as equation 1 and this is equation 2. Then solving these two equations, take addition, yy get cancelled, 2x is equal to 14, that is x is equal to 7. Substitute x as a 7 in equation 1 or 2, that is x plus y is equal to 10. Means if you substitute x as a 7, that is y is equal to 10 minus x, that is y is equal to 10 minus 7, that is 3. Means y is equal to 3. Therefore solution is xy is equal to 7, 3. This is something next video we study the next point, that is a practice set 1.2.